Part one of our exclusive interview with music mogul Sean Jay-Z Carter. The Brooklyn-born rapper is the subject of a massive, and massive is a word, exhibit at the Brooklyn Public Library. It's the first one of the scope ever held there. It's called Book of Hove, Hove, of course, being one of his nicknames. Since it opened in July, hundreds of thousands of people have visited, and the library says, listen to this number, it's seen a 97% increase in new card accounts across all of its locations. You know, you have days where you really love your job. This is one of those days for me. Why? Because Jay-Z gave us a personal tour of the exhibit, and then he sat down for a very rare interview.
May I give you the Book of Hope?
Sure. Thank you.
Now tuned into the greatest. Turn the music up in the headphones.
The Book of Hove exhibit at Brooklyn Public Library begins outside with a breathtaking display of Jay-Z's lyrics covering the building's walls.
You grew up, what, a couple miles from here?
Yeah.
So you're very familiar with this building. Hey! Look how they can...
That's right.
I love that. So when you drive by Jay and you see words to your songs on the library.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. It's fascinating. I didn't think that it would be so grand.
So grand?
Yeah.
Well, what did you think? It couldn't be a little exhibit.
I thought it was just like a little exhibit, like, you know, to get like...
A room?
I mean, a room. From rags to riches, I ain't dumb. I got
99 problems, but a... Inside the installation created by Jay-Z's company, that would be Roc Nation, you'll find the scope of the rapper's body of work and origin stories, including this hand symbol.
Let's start here, because it's my understanding that your team did this for you and you didn't really know what they were doing. What did you think was happening?
I didn't know anything about it, but when they asked me to do an impression for the hands, I did the impression. And I didn't even question, I just left it alone.
What does this mean? I know it means Rockefeller and Diamonds, but where did you get that idea from to do that?
When we first started, we had a group called Christian. When you sell 10 million, you go diamond.
Diamonds. Okay.
Right? We believed in them so heavy, it was like, this group is gonna sell 10 million records. So we started putting the diamond up for Christian. That's how it all came about. And then we started playing with it, and then you start doing it at shows, then the whole crowd started doing it and just stuck.
Jay-Z's music career spans over three decades. His 13 studio albums are all highlighted here.
We have to start with Reasonable Doubt, because no record label wanted to do this.
Rightfully so. I think I needed to grow into this album right here. And had I gone to a label, I don't think I would have been able to fully explore what was really happening.
Really?
Because I had the freedom and like the independence to like really talk about like the real stuff that was happening in the streets and happening for me and my friends at the time.
Uh-huh.
You know, record labels would probably say, yo, you need a big hit.
Yes.
You need this.
Yes.
Let's go get.
When you look at these covers, are there stories that come to mind for you when you're looking at them?
Yeah. So this album was the streets' favorite.
Yeah.
This album, I was trying to go into like the music business. So the first song I made for this album, Streets Is Watching, that's the last song I played for Biggie. He kept saying, play it again. And then I gave him it was on the cassette. When the streets is watching, blocks keep blocking, waiting for you to break, make your first mistake. I'll never forget, like, he looked back, he's like, the whole album's gonna sound like this? And it was almost like, it was playful, but it's also almost like, he's coming. From standing on the corners, popping, to driving some of the high. This is the album that was
Hard
the
life.
Most important album, because it was the album where I honed my craft as a songwriter. And that balance of creating exactly what I want and just as a writer, a technical song maker. Song making skills with real stories is when it all came together on this album.
I'm gonna try not to do this too many times on the tour, but honestly, when I walked in this room and just take a look at all of the visuals of you up there, what does this mean to you? I mean, it's your face everywhere. I can't imagine.
No, it's unbelievable. First of all, it's Brooklyn. Let's start there, right? It's
just what like,
it's in Brooklyn.
What does Brooklyn mean to you, Jay-Z, Sean
Carter?
Yeah, that's
everything. It's everything. Yeah, I'm out at Brooklyn. Now I'm
down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. You know what else I think is so interesting? Number one, it's in the library. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. And it's free and accessible to everybody. Because people would pay to go see an exhibit like this.
Yeah.
But your team decided they wanted it, A, in Brooklyn. They wanted it in a library so everybody could see it.
Really important. And that, I love that.
Big pimpin', baby.
Come on, you gotta talk quiet in the library.
I know.
Big pimpin', spinning cheese.
This room I like in particular because one of the great lyrics I love that you did, I'm not a businessman, I'm a business, comma, man.
I'm not a businessman, I'm a businessman.
I love that lyric. The way your play on words is genius.
It's a space, thank you. It's one I'm proud of as well because it's really the, it's a simple phrase, but the space gives it meaning.
Turn my vocal up some more.
And the business-minded mogul has pursued everything from fashion to football.
Super Bowl goals.
In 2022, the halftime show he helped produce made history, winning an Emmy for Outstanding Variety Special. That was a Super Bowl first. That beat out the Grammys, that beat out the Tonys for the best show, and it was 13 minutes.
Yeah.
What'd that mean to you?
For me, as a kid growing up on like Snoop and Dre and all of them, and like being a fan of what they do on the West Coast, to be a part of something that had them on stage in LA, and the fact that it never happened before is one of the things that, you know, I take pride in, like pushing the culture forward.
Hove did. Please don't forgive me for what the stove did.
And he's using his platform to push for change in the justice system. In 2019, Jay-Z helped launch the Reform Alliance with a goal of transforming the country's approach to probation and parole.
It's not an easy job. This is a really tough space to deal with. And I think
it means something to you.
Yeah, because I think at the end of the day, we're losing a lot of mentors and a lot of people that would be positive members of society.
Double your money and make a stack.
Our tour also showcased one of Jay-Z's biggest business moves, reclaiming his music. Now these, I love it. These are the masters, Jay, as you know. People are selling their masters these days. Would you ever sell your masters?
No.
Never?
No.
Why not?
I get why people do it. I've been fortunate enough to make money in this place. But for me, was the fight of my life. You know, from being an independent company from the beginning, and then going through the Def Jam system, not really understanding how that works, and them having my masters, then going back to Def Jam as the president, and then saying, okay, I'll do this job, and part of this job is my masters has to be revert back to me. Just, you know, it was my kids to see my work. You know, and if they decide to sell it, then it's up to them.
My stake in Roc Nation should go to you. Leave a piece for your siblings to give to their children, too. Title to champagne, do say I'd like to see.
I'm fascinated by your process of not writing things down. How are you able to have that in your head? How do you keep track of all of that, I guess, is what I want to know.
I've lost a lot of songs that way. I've lost a lot of material, but it just came. It just came like just life. Life is, you know, I was every night writing in that notebook that my mom gave me. It had no lines on it. When I started getting outside, you know, moving further away from my mother's house, start running the streets, these ideas, they would come, and then I would run into a store. So I'm on the corner.
Yeah.
And I would write it on a paper bag, and I put it in my pocket until I got home. Then I would transfer it to a book. But then ideas come, more paper. Then I'm getting further and further away. I had to memorize ideas until I got back.
Let's go.
You have a very unique way of moving, too.
I'm feeling every little hi-hat, snare, et cetera, and the space in between. So sometimes I'll jerk like that because there's a space in between that I'm trying to feel.
I'm fascinated by the trajectory of your life. Because it could have gone so left so many different ways, so many different times. Do you even find yourself, even today sometimes, I can't believe that this has happened to me, even
now? You won't believe how many times that I do that a week. I do
Seriously?
That all the time.
I still think about what you mean to people in terms of you walk in a room, people know that you're in the room. You have your hands in many different pots. And I'm trying to figure out what matters most to you. Can you even pick anything like that?
I think what matters most is today is being a beacon and helping out my culture, people of color. I think I pull the most satisfaction from that. Like making music early was like My first love. I could sit there for hours. It consumed me.
Yeah.
Just finding words and figuring out words and how to say this and different ways to say that and different pockets and melodies and how to write this song. That consumed me. That's why my pace was so fast. I had so much material. And I think now, you know, the idea of taking that platform and reproducing it for others or doing something like Reform, et cetera, et cetera. I think I derived the most joy from that.
I can't even begin to say what this interview meant to me. This is a man who's so talented, so compassionate, so committed to what he does. And I look at what he's done. The night that we were there, number one, Jay had a cold, so he's like, don't get too close, I have a cold. I go, I don't care.
Yeah, like,
I don't care that you have a cold.
Give me that virus.
Give me that virus, I'll take some of that. So he didn't feel as great, but that didn't stop him. He was very engaged. But that night, he and his mom, Dr. Gloria Carter, another powerhouse, they were being honored for their philanthropic work in Brooklyn. They raised $1.5 million. Mm. And I'm holding this library card because the library, the attendance there is up 553%. They have new library accounts. So they've done a special library card, 13 of them, that represent Jay's albums. They said, Gail, would you like one? I go, yes. And they gave me 13. I said, thanks.
Amazing.
That is incredible.
I'll share.
Please share with us. I was going to take that anyway.
Nate, it's like I was going to walk out with these.
But it's extraordinary, though, hearing his process.
But that was what I was going to ask you about, because I listen to music, and you guys know this. I love lyrics. That's,
yes,
for me, is where I derive my joy from music. And when I hear him say that he talks about the space in between and how he's trying, when you ask him about businessman, man, the space in between of those words is what gives it its power. I love that.
And that's why you can look at rappers as musicians.
Yes.
And he's
and
both.
Poets.
And I've always said, if you take some of the best lyricists in the world and you put their lyrics on a wall, it will be perceived as poetry and art. And Jay-Z has always been that type of artist. And I'm glad that we have done this. And you pointed out that the significance of it being in a library is special.
Yes.
For so long,
that mattered a lot to him.
Even
though he didn't know
rappers.
About it, even though he didn't know they were doing it, it mattered a lot when it was in the library and the Brooklyn Library. And guess what? We have more tomorrow.
We got a part two?
We got a part two, Nate. The second part of our interview with Sean Jay-Z Carter in just a moment, we'll find out the answer to this burning question. Is Jay-Z a cool dad?